Law and Crime Network. Again, we've been covering the Roy Oliver murder trial in Texas. He's a former police officer on trial for the murder of 15-year-old Jordan Evans. Now, Roy Oliver says that the vehicle Jordan was in attempted to run him over. He was in fear of his life, so he fired into that vehicle. Just before that, police were at a party where shots were fired, and you can see that vehicle backing up just before the shooting. We've been covering this trial all day. That jury is on lunch right now. That courtroom's on lunch. But we have a very, you can see Jordan there on your screen. We have a very special guest joining us right now, former Dallas City Council member Tiffinni Young, who's actually doing some freelance work for the Law and Crime Network exclusively there in the courtroom. Tiffinni, how are you this afternoon?
Yes, hi. I'm doing good this afternoon.
Great. Thanks so much for joining us. Real quick, what is the environment like in that courtroom? I know you've been there pretty much all day, most of yesterday. What is the environment like in that courtroom?
Yes, I can tell you it's not as tense as some may have expected. There are members of the community that are attending the trial. You have the family, Jordan Edwards' family and friends that are attending the trial. And then there are also, I believe, some members that are attending the trial on behalf of the defense. But the mood has not been tense. It has been one that has been very intense mood, just in terms of the different hearings that have taken place, and at times a very emotional situation, especially as the friends of Jordan Edwards and his stepmother have been on the witness stand.
Right, and you mentioned his stepmother. How is the family? What are their reactions? Because we've seen some pretty traumatic testimony here, especially Maxwell Everett, who we just heard from prior to that courtroom breaking for lunch, and how he thought Jordan had spilled the drink. What has been their reaction as far as their emotions during this trial?
Yes, I can tell you the family we have not been able to see some of the raw emotion that family members or friends may have, because many of them are witnesses that have not been released from their testimony there yet. And so they have not been in the courtroom for some of the testimony. The stepmother and the father and other family members have been in the courtroom. And so there's been emotion in the stands, in the gallery, and there at times tears are flowing. And so it's very emotional to have to, I guess, relive that moment.
Right. Absolutely. I could only imagine. So have you had a chance where you're sitting in the courtroom? Can you actually see the jury? What is the jury makeup, if you have that? And what has been their reactions to some of this testimony going on?
Yes, I do have that in front of me. So it is a mostly female jury. We do have, and there are two African-American females. There are, and it is a little bit difficult to determine, but there are four males, eight females, and it appears that there are two African-American women and the rest are Anglo, quite possibly a Hispanic on the jury.
Got it. And during some of that testimony, especially Maxwell's testimony, was there a reaction? Because Maxwell, he basically broke down in tears, if our viewers are just joining us, when he was describing what happened to Jordan.
Yes, the jury has been quite attentive to the proceedings thus far. At times when it's been jovial in the courtroom, the jury does laugh some. For it to be an all-female jury, you can sometimes see the emotion in some of the female members of the jury. I can imagine they're thinking, that could have been my child. And so you do see some of that. But there are some jurors who have kind of kept a poker face throughout the proceedings.
Got it. And really quick, Tiffinni, how has the defendant in this case, Roy Oliver, how has he been acting in the courtroom? We have about 30 seconds.
So I cannot see his face, but I can tell you he's been communicating with his attorneys. His partner testified yesterday on the first day of trial. It seemed as if he kind of kept his head forward, trying to make eye contact with his partner when he was testifying, his former partner.
Absolutely. Tiffinni Young, reporting exclusively from the courtroom there in Texas in the Roy Oliver murder trial. We appreciate you so much. I know you have to get back in court soon. That will be resuming here in just a few minutes. So we appreciate your time. Thanks for joining us here at the Law and Crime Network.
Yes, thank you.